legend lives on from old Brooklyn on down of the wreck of the Hillary Clinton. The White House was hers, they had told her for sure, there's no way that the orange man will get in. With a load of donor cash, many $1 million more than Don Trump's enterprise had control of. The Clinton campaign was to suffer much pain when the votes of November changed motives. Her crew was the pride of the liberal side, coming out from the Democrat contest. As candidates go, she was way worse than most, but she had on her side media broadcasts. Concluding that she couldn't win on herself, she set out to tear down the Donald. Little did she know he would go on to show he was more like the one they called Ronald. When fall came around, their campaigns hit the ground. Both of them had their share of misfortune. Hillary fell and Donald couldn't tell whether he should even try to win. The debates were all tests of presidentness, and most said that Hillary won them. For in all three affairs, Donald dwelt on his cares, plus he did have to deal with some nose phlegm. When October came, the surprises were out, and boy were they hard on the Trump team. A pussy remark gave his party a rout, his campaign almost lost all of its steam. But Donald held on and refused to be gone, though many protested against him. The rest of the fall, he doubled down on the gall that had earned him his primary big win. Does anyone know where the love of God goes when elections turn minutes to hours? The pundits had said Comey's letter was dead, but the night defied their guessing powers. At first it had seemed that they'd all shout yes, Queen, when the exit polls presaged her victory. Yet the Donald came through where the Great Lakes are blue, in the states where the weather is wintry. Pundits were told that the blue wall would hold, no way the Great Lakes could become red. But the night would go on to prove them all wrong on Penn, Michigan, and Wisconsin. As farther below the swing states would go, the Great Lakes had pushed Trump to conquest. They voted for him even though he had been rated by most as dishonest. swanky new pad. In Brooklyn they cried for the doom of the Democrat Party. On Twitter they wailed, for their efforts had failed, though they thought that their base had been hardy. The legend lives on from old Brooklyn on down, of the wreck of the Hillary Clinton. Elections, they learn, must be actually earned, lest the votes of November go trumpin'.